Probability and luck play a big hand in tonight's episode, but at the same time, I have to wonder if they didn't kind of rush that explanation a bit. Welcome to the heart of the stories we tell. My name is Rob, and tonight I will be reviewing Luck Be a Lady, episode 3 of season 4. Luck be a lady tonight. Luck if you've ever... Alright, sorry. No more singing. We get a quick explanation of what happened when the Speed Force opened up both times, and we also get a new villain. But for the most part, we're just learning about what happened to Barry, and we get some Iris and Barry interplay that is kind of interesting because it juxtaposes with what's going on with their father and his current relationship. All in all, it's a good episode. I do have to say, though, all the people that are saying this isn't Barry, this would be an awful lot of wasted character growth and episodes if there was not a hint that it was Reverse Flash, but it's really been him this whole time. And like I said, they just introduced a new villain that obviously this was Barry's way of dealing with because he was trying to be nice. For those of you that don't know, I do reviews like this of The Flash and other superhero and interesting shows every couple of days as they come out, movies as well, but I also try to put together theory videos on the hows and whys we tell stories every Sunday. I do a throwback Thursday to talk about older ones that have been out for a while. If that sounds interesting, hit subscribe. For now, let's talk about this episode of The Flash. And like I said, we're talking about luck and probability, but let's throw this up there in case you weren't lucky enough to see it. So once again, it's stop. Spoiler time. Say hello to Havoc. She was born under an unlucky star, and then she got probability manipulation powers, because this man manipulated it. But did he really? I mean, think about all the things that went into this. How could the Thinker have planned to have Barry run out somewhere where there would be people? How could he have planned any of this, really? I mean, yeah, there's the whole chess master thing, and it kind of annoys me that we had to watch him play chess the way we had to watch him rewrite a symphony last week. I get it. He's a nerd. He's smart. He calls people plebeian for abbreviating Rebecca to Becky, even though that's just a really normal thing to do. And even his little assistant here kind of took a jibe at him. I guess they're smarter than you think. Which is kind of cool, because the reason I haven't done Legends of Tomorrow videos is because of how much they've been playing them up as dumb. I like when my heroes have a little more intelligence. But let's talk about what happened with the Speed Force. Because Barry ran out of it, he ripped some of that dark energy out of it. And when he did, it created new metas. A whole busload of them. I believe they said 12 at the end of the episode. So, we have a couple of episodes for that to take point. But let's talk about this Becky, our villain of the week. She didn't even know of herself as a villain. Yeah, she did some kind of bad things, but really she was just getting lucky. And I have to say that this episode suffered from not really explaining how the probability manipulation works. In the old DC role-playing game, there was a probability manipulation that allowed things to happen. And I actually had a person play in the game that played a gypsy-like character that could do it. And we constantly argued over what was and wasn't an acceptable use. And my default rule was always, if there's zero physical chance of it happening, no, you can't say, oh, what were the odds of that happening? Because the odds were zero. Star Trek had a similar explanation for luck in one of their episodes. I believe it was Deep Space Nine. They saw something on the molecular level turning 60 and 70% one way instead of the other when it should be 50-50. And as such, luck broke out. However, at the end of the day, even with its scientific explanation and flashes, they still did the same corny good luck, bad luck thing. Things that can't be attributed to luck, things that are not chance, went wrong because you were unlucky. Now, yeah, the house falling apart stuff was kind of funny, and the stuff with Iris and Barry losing out on the place that they wanted to get married was funny, but realistically, let's really think about this for a second. What were the odds of any of that happening? Was it 1%? Was it 0.5%? The amount of bad things just seemed very contrived for comedy's sake. And yes, I know they're trying to do more comedic with the episode. But they also are trying to put in more of the human element. And with that, we're ramping up towards the wedding. So, Iris got her wedding dress, which those of us that have been looking for set pictures have already seen, and only the bad luck stopped them from rushing in and having an elopement tonight. So, all in all, I do think that that's an interesting way of taking it. I'm much more looking forward to a future episode where we see the bachelor and bachelorette parties. And I've already been spoiled on when the wedding's happening this season, but I won't go into it in case you don't want to know. Now, the Vibe and Harry stuff going on is always kind of touching, because you have to remember, Cisco and Harry of any world have a tight connection. You know, one that goes straight to the heart. Da-dun-dun. We didn't really get any Killer Frost stuff, but I do want to talk about the Wally thing. Because when he said, no one noticed I wasn't in this at all, and I haven't been around for a couple days, I felt like screaming at my TV. I noticed, I kept asking why Barry didn't have backup from Kid Flash. But I guess it's an excuse to get him out of the picture for a little ways. Although it's kind of cheesy, because like he said to his dad, I'm a speedster, I can come running whenever you need me. And that's the real problem with the Flash. You could live in New York City and be operating out of San Fran in a heartbeat. But at the end of the day, that's not the real big surprise ender. The surprise ender is who it is that is going to need the diapers. Because at the end of the episode, Lucille tells good old Dad West, Joe, I'm pregnant. The look on his face was magical. And frozen there as if he had been magically frozen. It's interesting because everyone assumes that the we're going to need more diapers line has to do with Iris. What do you think? Do you think that they're setting up for a whole bunch of kids next season? Do you think any network show like this would dare throw a bunch of kids in? Let me know down in the comment section. My personal hope is this is all a setup so that we can get Bart Allen by the end of the season. A speedster who's not a villain, one from the future, and one that could be really awesome. But then again, after watching how they misused Wally, eh. Now, it's time for me to ask you to like and share this video. If you enjoy what's going on, let me know. And of course, comment down below, and if this is your first time here, or you just haven't yet for whatever reason, click that subscribe button. What I'd like to do is build a community, one where we can talk about all of the things. And to be honest, the CW shows have been some of my lower-rated videos for views and thumbs up. So if you're really interested, now would be the time to show me. Leave a comment, a like, share the video with someone that you know would also like it. For now, I hope you have a good night, and thanks for walking with me through the heart of the stories we tell.